The race to find alternatives to Russian energy has accelerated after Moscow's decision to cut its supply of natural gas to Bulgaria and Poland.
Is another very stark reminder that we need to work with reliable partners and build our energy independence.
The European Union gets around 40% of its gas from Russia. But as the war in Ukraine rages on, the bloc said it aims to slash 2/3 of its purchases by the end of the year. To help cover this shortfall, the U.S. has ramped up shipments of liquefied natural gas, or LNG, to its Western allies. But this move has also begun to drain domestic supplies and is pushing up prices in the U.S.
We're pretty much tapped out. There's nothing more to send.
Here's why providing natural gas from the U.S. is so complicated, and what energy producers are trying to do about it. Even before Russia invaded Ukraine, domestic inventories of natural gas across the U.S. were already lean due to various factors. There have been extreme weather events like a cold snap in Texas that paralyzed power plants and helped drain global stockpiles. Plus, during the pandemic, U.S. producers tapped into their inventory of already drilled wells amassed over years instead of drilling new, costly wells. Draining their inventory kept them afloat financially, but has limited their ability to grow production now that fossil fuel demand is growing. Then came Russia's invasion of Ukraine and heightened calls on the EU to reduce its reliance on Russian energy. And to help with that transition, President Biden made a pledge.
We're taking additional steps in lockstep with our allies and partners to raise the economic pressure on Putin.
These steps come at a time when the amount of gas in storage in the lower 48 states is 17% below the five-year average for this time of year. Despite dwindling supply, the U.S. now aims to send 50 billion cubic meters of LNG to Europe every year until at least 2030. That would make up for about a third of the gas the EU receives from Russia.
Since the war, the U.S. has become the largest supplier of liquefied natural gas to Europe, but there's a limit to how much the U.S. can supply.
And for American producers looking to supply more LNG overseas, it's no easy feat. That's because transporting natural gas is more complicated than oil or coal. After the gas is drilled from the ground, it's put through a pipeline. It's then sent to a plant that functions like a massive refrigerator, where it's chilled into a liquid state for shipping.
That super refrigerator that turns it into a liquid, those are multi-billion dollar facilities. The ones that are running, that we have built right now, are running at full capacity.
And building these super refrigerators could take years.
Really, the earliest that additional U.S. supplies could be put on the market to Europe or anywhere is 2025, 2026.
The Federal Energy Regulatory Commission has given the green light to build 13 new LNG facilities in the U.S., but companies haven't started construction, largely because many haven't been able to secure the financing. And some producers are worried about whether there'll be a demand for LNG in the long run amid a global transition to cleaner energy.
What they need is commercial certainty that there's demand for this product, and not just demand now, but demand over the long term. So usually these projects are seeking 20-year supply deals because it can take as much as 7 years to even begin seeing a return.
But in the short term, as these options are debated, consumers will feel the pinch.
We are now the largest exporter of natural gas in the world. So there's just more demand for the gas coming out of the U.S., and that's going to push prices higher for the foreseeable future.